Hey everyone, welcome to my first video of 2016. Hope everyone's having a great year so far. So today I'm gonna be doing a rainbow pinup girl, and for this piece I used Prang watercolors, Sharpie fine tip pens, and Sharpie fine tip markers, as well as a variety of paintbrushes in different sizes. And for highlights, I used white acrylic paint. And I also used prismacolor colored pencils for this piece as well. And also the paper I used for this piece was Strathemore brand Bristol board paper. It is 100 pound weight and it comes in a pad of like 20 sheets or so. You can get it at like any art store like Michael's or Hobby Lobby, probably even Joann's Fabrics. And unfortunately for this piece, I somehow lost the video clip from when I was doing some of the sketching originally, missing probably like the first 15 minutes of the drawing. I just can't seem to find the file anywhere. I must have deleted it because I started drawing this piece all the way back in September, so it maybe when I was cleaning through some of my older video files, I might have accidentally junked it. But anyways, I'm doing this outline with the fine tip Sharpie pens, which are pretty good for outlining stuff. They don't bleed too badly, and they're pretty waterproof if you decide to go over them with watercolors, as I will be doing in this video. As you can see, I like to work with a lot of varying line widths. I'll do, you know, thinner lines here, and then I'll go back over certain lines a few times, especially like the outlines of the whole piece. It helps to give a little bit more style to a piece if you use varying line widths, especially if you're going for a more tattoo-y style look, because it's a real common method with like old school tattoos or traditional style tattoo flash. So now I'm going in with the watercolors. I've done a few different rainbow-haired pinup girls in the past, but I haven't done one since I started doing YouTube videos, so I thought it would be cool to show my process on how I do these. Takes a lot of color and a lot of patience because you gotta wait for little pieces of the hair to dry before going back and blending it or adding more colors. So for a lot of this piece, I'll go back and forth between different parts, between doing the skin and doing the hair and whatnot. And if you couldn't tell, this video is sped up fairly quickly. I have sped it up to 64 times speed. The video is like 8 minutes or so, but the actual painting time took around like 8 or 9 hours. Over the course of a few months. Like I said, I started back in September, but I've been working on it on and off in between other pieces because I can't really just focus and do all of one piece at once. I get super bored. I don't know if I have ADD or something, but either way, I get a lot more work done if I'm able to switch back and forth between different pieces. But that's just me. And also, as I said earlier, I am using the Prang watercolor set, P-R-A-N-G, professional watercolor set, which is fairly inexpensive. I've seen them at pretty much every art store I've ever been to, and I'm pretty sure you can get them online too. I just really, really love the color palette. The colors are so bright and they go so well together, and a lot of my pieces go really well together because I use the same color palette in a lot of them. Normally, I would just straight use the watercolors for color, but for this piece, I decided to experiment and try and see how would my prismacolor color pencils go over my watercolor, and would that look nice? And I think the result comes out well. I'm gonna probably start using color pencils a little bit later in this video, but I really liked the way it came out. It made the colors blend a lot better than if I was just using the watercolors alone. Of course, if you're gonna do color pencils over your watercolors, you've gotta let the watercolors dry completely. And I'm sure the brand of watercolors you use will affect how well the color pencil goes over it. But I feel for Prang, as long as you don't go super thick with the watercolors, the color pencils go pretty well over them. So I'm still working on the watercolors here. As far as the pranks that goes, I used brown for the skin tone and just did really light layers of it and then went back over it a few times. And I thought a black rose would be nice contrast to the face, but later on I decided to go over it with some purple because it was just a little too plain for me. Oh, I say so much in this video. Sorry about that. So right now what I'm doing is going back over those original black outlines with my Sharpie pen and markers, and I'm also getting started on some of the colored pencils on the face. The reason I had to go back over the original black outline is because that pigment in the watercolor is so thick that even though the Sharpies are pretty much waterproof and they don't bleed from it, they will get covered up with the lighter pigment and become faded. So I will have to go back over them with the Sharpie pens and Sharpie markers. And then here's what I'm talking about with the Prismacolor colored pencils. Decided to go over all the skin tone so I could get a nice even shade in, because I wasn't able to accomplish it with the brown paint as well as I wanted to on the Bristol board paper. Bristol board paper works sometimes with watercolors, but the more water you use, the more the paper starts to get eaten up. So at that point, I decided that the colored pencils would be a nice idea to try to get that skin tone nice and smooth the way I wanted it to look. And for that background, I quickly went in with a little bit of water and then threw over some paint. And then I used a paper towel, which you saw me dabbing, to kind of pick up some of the color, leave a really cool kind of effect. Did some splatters here and there. This is a technique I use a lot for backgrounds. It's so hard to come up with great background ideas, but sometimes less is more. And you don't want to take away from your subject by making a background that's too crazy. So I'll try to just do something simple that accents the piece well. And then I go back in with the more colored pencil and do some highlights on the skin with the light purple, because I think it goes well against that light blue. It's not too similar that it gives it a nice little flare or whatever. Can't think of the word. So yeah, and then the next step is going back in with some white acrylic paint. I'm throwing in some highlights, doing a little bit of a white outline around the subject so she kind of pops a little bit better with all that color. And that's about it. That's all there is to it. Thanks for checking out my video. Be sure to check out my Facebook and Instagram. I will leave links in the description, as well as my Etsy store where I sell prints, originals, and more. And be sure to stop by for more videos. Excited for a lot of new videos this new year. Thanks so much for checking out my channel. And as I said before, have a happy, happy new year. Toodles!